Hello everyone, welcome back to Chinda DIY. In today's video, I'll be showing you how to crochet a corset top. It is really easy pattern and friendly for beginners. And for this corset top, it is for size small and size medium. And I also tell you how to make it bigger in this video. Okay, now let's get started. This is how the process of making this top looks like. We are working on the length way. And for this top, we have two sides, the increasing side from A to E and the decreasing side from G to K. But first, we are start making the part A, which is the back part of the top. To begin, make a slip knot. And chain 19, it is equal 5 inches length, is the height of the back part of the top. If you guys want it longer, please add more chains. After you got 19 chains, next we are going to make lemon peel stitch. For row 1, skip 1 chain and make single crochet into the second chain. To make single crochet, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 2 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 2 loops. After you have made a single crochet, next we are going to make double crochet into the next stitch. To make double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 3 loops on your hook, yarn over, pull through 2 loops, and yarn over, pull through 2 loops again. Next, keep alternate single crochet and double crochet into every chain until the end of the row. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, and this is what the first row of lemon peel stitch looks like. For the last stitch of my first row, it's end with a single crochet. So for row 2, you must start with a double crochet. Chain 1, turn your work and make a double crochet into the stitch near chain 1. Thank you. After you have made a double crochet, then make a single crochet into the next stitch. Remember, below a single crochet stitch must be a double crochet stitch, and above the double crochet stitch must be a single crochet stitch. Keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, this is what the second row of lemon peel stitch looks like. So for the last stitch of my second row, it ends with a double crochet, and for row 3, you must start with a single crochet. Chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the stitch near chain 1. After you have made a single crochet, then make a double crochet into the next stitch. Keep alternating single crochet and double crochet into every stitch until the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. For the next row, please keep repeating row 2 and row 3 until you reach row 13. It is equal 4 inches length. If you guys want your top bigger, please add more rows. After you reach row 13, then don't forget to use stitch marker to mark at that 13th row. And next, we are going to make the part B. We are going to increase for both sides, for the underarm part and for the bottom part of the top. So continue from where your last stitch is. For part B, we are start count as a row 1 again. Chain 1, turn your work, and we are going to make increase by make 3 stitches in the same loop. And remember, for those 3 stitches, we still keep alternating single crochet and double crochet stitch the same. After you have made 3 stitches in the same loop, next, keep making lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. after you had one last stitch, then we are going to make increase, but make two stitches in the same loop. After you have made two stitches in the same loop, next for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. So for row 2, no increase. After you reach the end of the row, for the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal to 2 inches length. It means that you are going to make one row with increase and one row without increase. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at that 6th row. Next, we are going to make the part C, which is increase only the bottom part. And this is in case for you guys want to know how to count the number of the row. As you can see, this horizontal line for this line and this line, it is count as 2 rows, 2 rows, and 2 rows. Or you can remember what the stitch looks like, and this is the front side of the stitch or the right side of the stitch. As you can see the stitches, it counts as one row, and when you flip it back, you can see the back side or the wrong side of the stitch. You can see this is the first row and this is the second row. Okay, now let's move to the part C. For row 1, chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have one last stitch, then I will meet you back again. After you have one last stitch, then we are going to make increase by making 2 stitches in the same loop. After you have made 2 stitches in the same loop, next follow 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. For row 2, no increase. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal to 2 inches length. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at the 6th row. Next, we are going to make the part D, which is more curved. So part D, for row 1, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 1 last stitch. Then we are going to make increase by make 3 stitches in 1 loop. After you have made 3 stitches in the same loop, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. For row 2, no increase. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal to 2 inches length. And for you guys want your top bigger, please add more row at the part C and this part D. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at that 6th row. Next, we are going to make part E. So part E, for row 1, chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 1 last stitch. Then we are going to make increase by make 2 stitches in 1 loop. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 4. It is equal 1.5 inches. So for the measurement from part B until part E, it is measuring from the underarm to the middle part of your chest. Like I said, if you guys want your top bigger, please add more rows until you reach the middle part of your chest. Next, we are going to make the part F, which is the middle part of the top. Start from row 1 until row 6, we just make normal lemon peel stitch, no increase, just a straight line. Next, let's move to decreasing side by start from the part G. So for the middle part, which is the part F, after you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at that 6th row. And for that 6th row that you mark, it is count as the first row of the part G. Next, part part G for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 2 together. To make single crochet 2 together, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 2 loops on your hook. Then continue insert the hook into the next loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and now you have 3 loops on your hook. Yarn over and pull through all 3 loops, and this is how we made single crochet 2 together. Next, for row 3, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row, no decrease. For row 4, please repeat row 2. Remember, for the increasing side and the decreasing side must be have the same number of the row. After you reach row 4, then use stitch marker to mark at the 4th row. Next, we are going to make part H. Part H, for row 1, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. No decrease. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 3 together. To make single crochet 3 together, insert the hook into the loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and then continue insert the hook into the second loop, yarn over and pull up a loop, and then continue insert the hook into the very last loop, yarn over and pull up a loop. And now you have 4 loops on your hook, yarn over and pull through all 4 loops. And this is how we made single crochet 3 together. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal 2 inches length. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at that 6th row. Next, we are going to make part I. Part I, for row 1, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row, no decrease. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 2 together. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal 2 inches length. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at the 6th row. Next, we are going to make part J, which is going to decrease for both sides. Part J, row 1, chain 1, turn your work, make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 3 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 3 together. Next, for row 2, chain 1, turn your work and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until you have 2 last stitches. Then we are going to make decrease by make single crochet 2 together. For the next row, please keep repeating row 1 and row 2 until you reach row 6. It is equal 2 inches length. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach row 6, then use stitch marker to mark at the 6th row. For the last part, it is the back part of the top. We are going to make normal row without decrease. Part K, from row 1 until row 13, chain 1, turn your work, and make lemon peel stitch into every stitch until the end of the row. Like I said, for both sides of the top, must be have the same number of the row. After you got 13 rows, next we are going to make single crochet around the top. To begin, continue from where your last stitch is and make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the corner. Then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner part, we are going to make increase by make 2 single crochet into the same stitch. Next, make single crochet into the next 4 stitches. Then skip 1 stitch and make single crochet into the next 2 stitches. Then skip one stitch and repeat by make single crochet into the next two stitches, then skip one stitch until you reach the corner, then I will meet you back again. And at the corner part, please make 2 single crochet into the same stitch, then continue make single crochet into every stitch until you reach the end of the row. After you reach the end of the row, next we are going to make the corset holes. It is for the back lace. To begin, chain 2 and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. After you have made 5 single crochet, then chain 2, skip 2 stitches, and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Keep repeating this until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to continue make single crochet into every stitch around until you reach the other corner part, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the corner part, then we are going to make the corset holes. But repeat the same thing like the first side. After you reach the end of the row, then we are going to make slip stitch. Chain 1 and cut off the yarn. For the remaining yarn, please use the knit needle to weave in. And this is what the top looks like. Next, we are going to make the strap for the top. To begin, count 4 stitches from the corner and attach the yarn into the 5th stitch. Then chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. After you got 5 stitches of single crochet, next for row 2 until row 55, chain 1, turn your work, and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. For the measurement from row 1 until row 55, it is equal 11 inches length. If you guys want your strap longer, please add more rows. And this is what it looks like after you reach row 55. Next, we are going to connect the strap into the back part of the top. To begin, turn the strap wrong side out. Slip stitch into the first stitch. And then single crochet both sides together until you reach the end of the row, then I will meet you back again. After you reach the end of the row, then make slip stitch, chain 1 and cut off the yarn. And this is what the strap looks like after you flip it back. Next, we are going to make the other strap. To begin, attach the yarn into the corner part. And then chain 1 and make single crochet into the next 5 stitches. Please keep repeating the same thing like the first strap and then I will meet you back again. And this is what the top looks like after you have connected the strap. Next, for the back lace, make 300 chains. If you guys want it longer, please add more chains. Thank you. And now your course setup is done. If you like this tutorial, please don't forget to click like and leave a positive comment down below. Stay safe and stay healthy, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye bye.